Hey, James here to tell you what the Fox Metallica's been doing lately. At least Lars and I on our summer vacation. Sifted through about 302 shows of live shit and threw it into a mini Metallica roadcase. Yeah, finally some Metallica live shit. Well, basically the whole idea behind this is to share with you three shows in their entirety from foreplay to cleanup. There's two on vid and one on your choice of cassette or CD. Now, the videos were from San Diego during the last tour and Seattle from the Justice Thang in August of 89. Music on the CDs from one of five nights in Mexico City, along with a few older tunes thrown in there, sounds slightly fucking rockin'. Along with this, we put in every photo we could find and a few amusing and stupid documents into a thick-ass book, and threw in a sneak bit pass, wow, and a stencil of the notorious scary guy so you can help display some artwork where you feel necessary. So now that we've cleaned house, it's almost 9 hours of live shit from Metallica, if you can handle it. Three videos and three CDs, now binge and purge. Happy overdose and merry fucking Christmas from Metallica, man!
Ah! we thought we'd bring a new friend out with us here and do an old tune. Hope you guys are gonna fucking dig it. We fucking love playing this shit here. So I'm gonna bring our friend out, Mr. Robert Halford.
Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah! Fight. We're gonna do an old priest tune, right?
Yeah!
Tell them what it's all about.
This is a song from a Priest album called British Steel.
Yeah!
You gotta remember that one, don't you?
Yeah!
It's called Rapid Fire! Yeah.
Metallic greetings. This is Lars Ulrich from Metallica, and you are listening to The Metal Show on WCSB here in Cleveland.
This is James Hetfield from the band Metallica, and you're listening to Bill Peters on Metal Show, WUJC 88.7. Yeah! This is James Hetfield from the band Metallica, and we're ready to kill on the Headbang Metal Show with Mike Griff. This is WCSB 89.3. Yeah!
There you go. That was...
I'm Cliff Burton from Metallica, and I'm talking to Mike Griff from fucking Loud Cleveland, the Headbang Metal Show, WCSB 89.3, on your FM knob.
The reason we went with Elektra in the first place was because they were the most open-minded of the major labels. They gave the most creative freedom to the bands and stuff like that, and now you got a bunch of guys that are running the label whose background are much more corporate, who don't care about the bands as much as the predecessors, who look much more at the money and the bottom lines and so on, and we're not interested in working with them under those terms. So Metallica will now, you know, walk and pursue something else. The one thing that we wanted from them one day was to go in and talk to them about us owning our own records, which in record company lingo is basically, it's called the masters. You get your masters back, which means that the songs that we write and the songs we recorded, we end up having control and ownership over, so they can't give them to no shoe company or a toothpaste commercial or something like that. You know, we've had plenty of money. We're all very comfortable, so it was never about that. It was just about being in a situation where our songs would have the kind of value to them as they have to us, and that they wouldn't end up in a used car commercial or something. Me and James Hetfield are going to start writing the songs for the new record here in the next couple of weeks. Should be writing for the rest of the year in the studio, hopefully by January. So I'm sure that by the time the new record is actually ready to be released to the unsuspecting masses, that all this will be long gone history. But as far as we're concerned, our ties with Elektra are over, and we're walking.
Helpless. Yeah.
Don't get back!